Peace and blessings, everyone. This is Queenie Fama, and I am the truth terrorist. I know how that truth can hurt sometimes, but guess what? I got to do it, and I'm going to do it. You know why? Because I am a free thinker. No one, and I mean absolutely no one, controls my thought patterns and my processes. And I'm not saying that everything I say is correct or right or whatever for you. However, it is my thoughts that I'd like to share with you, my listening audience, my experiences, what I see going on in the world today, particularly in the black community. And we call it the black community, even though, you know, we got to understand what is a community. I mean, I've been wrestling with that for a long time, is why we're always called the black community, the Latino community, the Asian community, but we never hear the white community. We just hear white folk. So why is that? I mean, it just crossed my mind. I mean, I just don't get it. I don't get why we are so separated and marginalized in America. But you know what? My guy just brought a song over here by James Brown. I don't know if you heard the song by James Brown, but James Brown wrote a song a long time ago, right before he did Say It Loud, I'm Black and I'm Proud. He did a song called I Love America or I Am an American or something like that, something of that. It has a part one and a part two. My guy came all the way over here to bring me that song because I wanted to hear what James had to say. And, you know, as I listened to that song, I would say, yes, James, in a perfect world. But we're not in a perfect world. And for all intents and purposes, Africans in America, descendants of enslaved Africans, are a de facto nation that doesn't recognize its own nationhood. But one of my teachers, Dr. Amos Wilson, laid it out for me perfectly, and it made perfect sense as to the direction we must go in order to have some success on the planet and to be a force on the planet instead of always asking for a handout, begging, crying, please, please, please. Listen to me. Pay attention to me. Give me, give me, give me. When we have the power to create for ourselves and do for ourselves, it's right here in our hands, people. We just don't get it. And you know what? The queen is really, really tired of the bull crap. I really am. Because I recognize that we have the power. But I guess it could be because I'm 56 years old and I've seen some things. I've been through the Black Power movement. I've been through the civil rights movement. I've been through the feminist movement. I've been through the gay rights movement. I've been through the free us all movement. I've been through all the damn movements. And what I've concluded is that we, each and every one of us, have power. That's something I do know. And when we as individuals, as collective communities, as a group, allow someone to manipulate us to the point where we feel as though we have no power but our hat-in-hand ability to go begging and crying to someone else for our sustenance, it's a little downheartening when you can see, or whether I can see, you might be able to see it too out there in a listening audience, where you or we can see that it's just a matter of recognizing the concept of a nation within a nation. And we haven't gotten to that point yet, and I keep telling people that we haven't gotten to that point at this stage of the game. It's still an ideology. It's still something that we, some of us, look for, want, desire. But for some unsavory reason, we cannot seem to just get along with one another. We have so many divisions within our group. You know, you got the Christians, the Black Jews, you got the Muslims, you got the black Muslims, you have, I mean, it is so many divisions. It's the educated versus the uneducated, the light-skinned black versus the dark-skinned black, the living in the urban area black to the living in the suburban area black. I mean, we have so many divisions. It's hard to have a nation when everyone is so, have such a different view or different ideology. And to try to bring those together with the one commonality, the one understanding that we all have a common enemy, and we know who that enemy is, but it is not as though that enemy is all-powerful, even though we try to give life to a fictitious character who began this road down a slippery slope into hell. You know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about that damn Willie Lynch, who is not a real person, for the last time, because even I have recently heard a scholar mention Willie Lynch as though Willie Lynch was a real person. He is not, brothers and sisters. Now, we can take that now. You know, I'm going to tell you that creation, which was called the Willie Lynch theory. What we refer to out of that theory all the time is the damn letter, okay? But it was a whole theory, and in that theory, I'm quite sure people within this listening audience earshot has read the breaking of the African, and the language in the by itself would tell you that, you know, that was written in a more modern time. But we, and see, that's our crutch. We always seek to look for the blame for our problems when, you know, we have to have an understanding that, guess what? White supremacy go do what it do. Races are going to do what they do. But the challenge to us is, what are we going to do? We can't even agree upon how we're going to live as a people. What are the rules and regulations? What is the God we're going to worship? What kind of meals? What kind of food we eat? Some want to be vegetarian. Some want to be porkahonesis. Some want to be beefitarian. You know, and you got the whole discrepancy against that. The vegetarians say that the beef and pork eaters are somewhat a little crazy because they consume flesh. The meat eaters say that, hey, that's their source of protein, and can't nobody tell them what the hell to eat, which I wholeheartedly agree. And you have this plethora of self-appointed gurus and leaders and so forth and so on who want to dictate to everyone as the way we should go. And it's getting pretty difficult and confusing, particularly to our young people, as to where to go, which way to go, how should we bind together, band together as a people to pool our collective efforts, resources. You know, I was thinking about education the other day, you know, just post-thinking a conversation. And I had thought about black people and their education. And, of course, I've listened to a lot of our scholars, which is why I don't listen no more to anybody else, because I got all the references I need downstairs. And I remember listening to Dr. Bobby Wright, who spoke to that particular thing about education. Dr. Amos Wilson speaks to it as well. And they have concluded, and I wholeheartedly agree with them, that the current educational system is basically a training. You are trained to go into the larger society and do what you are trained to do. Now, the smart thing to do is to use your training to uplift, advance your own damn people. But the training is in such a way